Railway networks are constrained by network nodes, so where trains transfer from one line to another, essentially. They are safety critical assets, and the problem with them is that if they fail, you can no longer run trains over them. The point of repoint is to rethink that and add redundancy, so you can have what's known as a graceful degradation. So certain aspects can fail, but the train can still run over that asset. So you can do maintenance in the quieter times, so you'd have less delays on the network, less disruption to the passengers, and you can still generate revenue over that track.
So we have here three actuators. The idea being that any one of them can operate the system safely. So if any one of these should fail, that's transparent operationally to the railway. If one of them fails, the other two can continue to operate the system safely. Trains can continue to run. You're just aware of the fact that there's one of them that's failed and needs to be repaired at some stage. And in the meantime, the other actuators can keep operating the system safely and trains can continue to run. A conventional point machine slides the switch rails from one position to the other. And at either end of that travel, there's an active locking device that locks it in place so it's safe for trains to pass. But those machines are a single point of failure. If there is a failure on the system, then trains are stopped. Somebody has to go on site. It might take them time to get on site. And until they get on site and make a repair or secure the system, no trains can pass. Because we've gone for three point machines, we have to have a more of a passive locking mechanism. To switch from one position to the other, we first lift the rails and then throw them across to the other side and then lower them into position. Once they're back down on the other side, that means they're again mechanically locked and it's safe for trains to pass.
So for rail users, and I'm one of these rail users, we've all been on a platform at some point and there's been a single failure or a track failure. And these can, in many instances, be attributed to a track switch failure. And the current systems with their single points of failure mean that the whole network, in some cases, can stop. And so from the customer point of view, it's reducing that frustration of being on the network when it's failed and being able to get to what you need to do and get to that really important business meeting that you wouldn't have been able to do if a traditional track switch had failed.
It has the potential to be a significant contribution to the improvement of the reliability of points. I've been impressed by what I've seen today, if only because it's done what it set out to do, and in an undramatic way, which gives me some confidence that it's ready to go to the market.